Jennifer Love Hewitt bare naked? The ambitious girl who grew up on Party of Five has definitely grown up. In the next hour, Jennifer sets the record straight on that naughty website, losing her virginity on TV and the rumors about her love life.
Is it true? Is it not true?
Plus, we have a few surprises Jennifer doesn't see coming.
Am I going to cry?
Forget bare naked. Jennifer Love Hewitt, you're about to be revealed.
I thought that love sounded like a porn star. Everybody thought I had a boob job, which was really funny. If they only knew what a freak and nerd I was.
Hi, I'm Jules Asner. Jennifer Love Hewitt was just 9 years old when she convinced her family to pack up and move to Hollywood. Obviously, that gamble paid off. But as Jennifer told me, growing up on camera made her private life anything but private.
It's nice to see you.
It's nice to see you, too.
We've met a couple times,
yes,
briefly, but we've never had a chance to speak.
I'm a huge fan of the show, actually.
Yeah?
Okay. I'm slightly obsessed with it.
Well, you've come into E! Before. You've done Talk Soup. You've been a real trooper.
I'm a huge E! Fan. I am. I watch all the shows. I'm psyched. My mom and I, we sit at home, we watch, we're very excited.
Well, don't let them know that because they'll make you continue to come in and do stuff.
I hope so.
I'm not sure how much more Jennifer could fit into her schedule. She's been acting in films, recording her fourth album, shooting music videos, and hitting the publicity trail. Meanwhile, she's got the press breathing down her neck about her love life. We'll clear up that a little later.
Well, this has been such a busy time for you.
It's been amazing.
What have you been doing?
I've been on the road in a van doing a tour, a radio tour.
Now you're getting bare naked?
Yes. Bare naked in every city.
Bare Naked is Jennifer's first single from her album of the same name. And in case you couldn't tell from the sexy video, Jennifer's moved miles away from the girl next door she played on Party of Five. On the movie front, Jennifer has vamped it up as a con girl in Heartbreakers and kicked butt with Jackie Chan in The Tuxedo.
I'm at a weird age in Hollywood. It's strange to be 23 in the entertainment industry because acting-wise, you're kind of not really... You're not old enough to play the parts that you're really right for, and you're too old to play the parts that you could get, you know, very easily. and you kind of, you know, I'm sort of making that change from teen actress to adult actress.
Change is nothing new for Jennifer Love Hewitt. Her childhood was filled with it. She was born in Waco, Texas, and Jennifer wasn't her original name.
My mom was just going to name me Love Hewitt. My brother was 9 at the time, and he was afraid that people would think I was a freak if I just was named Love.
We live in this kind of small town. At the time I was 8, almost 9 years old. We might want to, you know, throw a buffer in there just in case when she's 13 this is not working out and she wants to go another direction. So there was a little girl that I was smitten with in elementary school named Jennifer.
And he's like, oh, I think Jennifer is the most beautiful name in the whole wide world because of the little chicky down the street. So that's how I got Jennifer. When I moved to L.A., I just went by Love Hewitt because that's what I've been my whole life. And then I did the show when I was 15, and they thought that Love sounded like a porn star. And so somebody just dropped something in the back. Did you hear that? I said porn star, and they went... But yeah, they thought it sounded like a porn star, and so they asked me if I had any other names that I could use. And I was like, well, my first name's Jennifer. And they said, well, can we add that? And so that's how that... So up until I'm 15, all the credits on things say Love Hewitt, and then afterwards they say Jennifer Love Hewitt.
What did your driver's license say?
Jennifer Love Hewitt.
Hewitt's parents separated soon after her birth. Her mother, Pat, moved the family to the tiny town of Killeen, just outside Austin. Yes, that's a Winn-Dixie. As a kid, Jennifer idolized Punky Brewster and found ways to make her own Punky power.
Even as a child, I can remember just always having some kind of little show, whether it was in the living room on Sunday, you know, lining up her dolls and putting on a full performance in front of the fireplace. Just any time anybody would sit down long enough to look at her, she was putting on a show.
According to her teachers at Nolanville Elementary, Jennifer was known as the talented one.
In the classroom, she would bring her karaoke little thing, and she'd sing, and the children would just sit in awe and listen to her, you know, and she'd belt out a song.
Jennifer grabbed every opportunity to perform, but in a town like Killeen, the opportunities were rather limited.
I was big at the livestock shows, and a scout came to one of those performances and picked myself to go to Russia and represent the United States as goodwill ambassadors. So I went to Russia when I was 8. Why? Not really sure. It was just my fate. And I went and I performed at communist youth camps, and I sang in Russian. And when I came back, there was a lot of publicity around it for, like, a little girl in Texas going to Russia to do such a thing.
Was your mother hesitant at all about letting you go? Did she go with you?
She went with me to Russia. Yeah, she was excited about going. My mom was more hesitant about letting me come to L.A., although she completely gave up her life in order for me to be here and, you know, live my dream. I think she was a little worried that, like, it would go badly or something. You know, she'd never been, you know, my brother's, like, completely normal. He's really intelligent, smart, beautiful, normal guy. And then here I am, and I'm like, I want to go to Hollywood. And my mom's like, whoa.
Coming up on Revealed, Jennifer hits Hollywood, but Hollywood hits back.
It was torture because I was freak girl.
Then the truth is in the tape.
I got a flash from the past for you. What is this? Am I gonna cry?
And later, we go down the love list.
We would be here forever.
February 20th, 1989, the day before her 10th birthday, Jennifer Love Hewitt and her family arrived in Hollywood. Jennifer convinced her mother to give her 1 month to land a singing or acting job, or the Hewitts could pack their bags and head home to Texas.
I was passed on by the record companies because I was 10 and they had no idea, you know, what to do with me at the time. It was before Hanson and all that stuff, and they, you know, they didn't know what to do. And so I was basically on my way home, and I went on an audition for Kids Incorporated.
Kids Incorporated was a popular variety show for the preteen set. Executive producer Thomas Lynch.
When she came in the room, she was so tiny, and she had a head of hair like this. She had this big mane of hair on her, and she, when I first saw her, she smiled, and her whole head was teeth, and I thought, okay, something's wrong with her. Out of all these children, out of 1,100 children, there was this beautiful little girl with a smile that just, you know, took the attraction. Everybody looked right at her.
Jennifer became friends with co-star Stacey Ferguson.
With Love, she not only moved away from school just for that summer, she moved away from her whole life, you know, because she was destined for this.
You knew she was a star. You just knew it. You knew that she had the internal strength to do it. She had the positive attitude to do it. And we shot, I believe, 3 shows a week, 6 days a week. And those shows were each probably 40 or 50 pages each.
It was all taping the show, so we had no life, basically.
The cast included Jennifer's future Party of Five co-star, Scott Wolf.
Scott Wolf had been on Kids Incorporated as a hottie, and we were all in love with him because we were like, oh, he's an older man.
I remember he was Scott Richard Wolf.
Oh my God, was he really?
He was Scott Richard Wolf.
Ooh. Oh, I'm gonna call him and ask him.
Despite the busy production schedule, Jennifer continued to audition for other gigs. She quickly landed her first commercial, then another, and another.
It could only be that Mrs. Morris is serving Mrs. Smith tonight.
Great. Hi, Mom.
Save a piece for your dad.
Uh-oh.
Jennifer appeared in commercials for Barbie dolls.
Where is the Barbie?
Plus a best-selling video called Dance Workout with Barbie.
It still haunts her. We still see it every now and then at Christmas or on, you know, some old special that they're doing, and she can't believe the big giant hair and the, woo, come on, girls, you know, that whole thing.
I got a flash from the past for you.
What is this? Am I going to cry?
You're no.
Girls, you
want to
dance?
You were so cute. Oh, I was so not cute. I was so in the middle of something, growing, sprouting something. Oh, look at my little leggings. Do people still wear those?
Yes, they do.
Yeah. We had rehearsals for this so we could this was a really hard workout. I still do this workout, by the way. Which is what's really depressing, because that you don't want to see me at home like,
okay. Oh, you want to know what's weird about this commercial? This is my last Barbie commercial. And it was my last Barbie commercial because I started to get boobs, and they had to ace bandage down my chest because Barbie girls don't have boobs.
But Barbie has boobs.
Barbie's allowed to. Barbie girls are not.
Wow.
I am so sorry. That is why I am where I am today. Oh, that is just scary.
In 1991, Jennifer Love Hewitt left Kids Incorporated to travel the world in a promotional show for sportswear giant LA Gear. Tutor Chris Canute.
We went to 7 countries in 7 weeks. She knew from day one that she was going to sing, dance, and act. There was no question. She was going to be successful at it.
I thought I had the voice to be a singer, so I decided that that's what I wanted to do.
The tour opened new doors for the 12-year-old. Jennifer recorded an album that soared to the top of the charts in Japan. One of the songs was written by one-time teen sensation Deborah Gibson.
She just had this great, spunky, young sound, and it was perfect for the song I had written, and that was it. And then when she came out and I became a fan of her work as an actress, I was like, hey, I'm feeling pretty cool because I wrote a song from Jennifer Love Hewitt.
Jennifer's career was taking off, and her life was anything but normal.
Your schooling was on sets a lot.
Yeah.
And through correspondence courses. Do you ever regret that?
I didn't like school very much. Children are cruel when they're that age. High school's hard, and junior high school especially. I went to junior high school for 7 months. And it was torture because I was freak girl that wanted to act, and you know, I didn't want to go to school dances. I had to leave and go to auditions because that was my thing and that's what I was into. And kids at that age are not into like respecting what you're into if you're not into the same things they are, you know. So I had a little bit of a hard time.
I bet you had really poor attendance too.
Really bad. But what's really strange is I was student of the year once, and I was only in my seat 16 days of the year.
Oh, God, now, I would hate you, too.
I know. It was really bad. I hated myself for that one. I was like, you've got to be kidding me. And the teacher's like, but see, she's traveling the world. She's actually going to the places in her history book. Like, how was I not going to get beat up?
Jennifer wasn't playing hooky. She was working, or at least trying to. She bounced from one series to the next, including Shaky Ground and McKenna. Both shows were canceled, but Jennifer continued to go on auditions.
I would think that'd be brutal.
It's a brutal process. It is definitely. I had quite a few days of tears just from, you know, like just crazy things where like other girls would spill Coca-Cola like all over your white shirt before you'd go in just because they knew that like maybe that would mean you'd have less of a chance at the job, and you'd be like, oh my, you little hoe, what are you, you know what I mean? It was just unbelievable.
In 1994, Jennifer was cast in the dramatic series Birds of Paradise. The show was filmed in Hawaii and co-starred Seth Green and Timothy Busfield.
I think we had a nice sort of father-daughter thing going on, and that was kind of special because she would say, I'd see her in the morning and I'd say, hello, lovey, and she'd say, hello, daddy.
She was 14 years old, and all these like 25-year-old island guys were like, oh, bro, fix me up with your sister. And I was like, you touch her, and I'll run you over with a monster truck and then start beating you up. You know what I mean? So I was very protective of her.
Birds of Paradise became strike 3 on Jennifer's TV resume. Jen was down, but not out.
By the time I got to Party 5, I was convinced that I was somewhat of a curse. And I told the producers, I was like, you may want to reconsider because I have this track record. Every show that I'm on is canceled. So sometimes they'd never even air. And then one day I was like 15 and a half and I came in and there was these sides and it said PO5.
Coming up on Revealed, Jennifer becomes number 6 on Party of 5.
It had to have been awkward though to lose your virginity on television.
And later, a web full of drama.
JenniferLovesPukeBoob.com or whatever it's called. Yeah.
1995, Jennifer Love Hewitt was calling herself the queen of canceled TV shows. Then her agent sent her a script with PO5 stamped on the cover.
I was like, okay, ding, ding, ding. Agent, hi. What is PO5? They were like, it's Party of 5, first of all, so don't make that mistake in the room.
Party of 5 was a drama on the Fox network. The show was struggling in the ratings. Still, Jennifer was excited because her former Kids Incorporated co-star, Scott Wolf, was a series regular. Executive producer, Chris Kaiser.
We were casting for Bailey's new, not even girlfriend, we were casting for Bailey's new friend. And the idea was we were going to cast a tomboy.
I never thought that I'd get it because I was so different than the rest of the girls that they had in there. They were all sort of older and these really glamorous people. And I was like scraggly and 15 in the middle of puberty and like completely weird.